second half of the morning untuk work in a group. So I would like to orientate us all. Meja, tempat duduk meja ni kita dah ikut pakuti eh. So nanti we will start discussing in your pakuti group lah. So engineering over there, over here is languages, over here is Islamic studies, and over there is Alamin. Alright? So after lunch, kita nak allow you to do some hands on yourself. And kalau ada question ke, nak minta tolong guideline sikit daripada Dr. Nacho boleh lah. Just to start lah. Because we understand, after the workshop, when you go back to your department, your faculty, you will have other things to do. Okay? So, seboleh-bolehnya, we do peer checking. Okay? The table tadi mention, kita dah buat-buat ni, kenalah orang check. Saya tanyalah balik. Siapa nak check tu? So, I would suggest from the beginning we were in groups and we do peer checking among each other. So that from the beginning kita sama-sama lah. Okay, it's kita dah biasa spectrum, kita dah biasa buat. Cuma nya when we do spectrum for undergraduate courses, we are there as a lecturer to provide the instruction. So even if our spectrum tu main letak je, no one feels so much negative impression. Because we are always there to back up balik. Okay? But when we do ODM, we are not there. So the instruction has to be very clear. So okay, when you start to do, Dr. Najwa akan start punya yang lebih technical macam ni. Try to check on each other's course lah. The instruction tu jelas tak? Check kawan punya, check kawan punya. Okay? So that bila dia habis, kita tak boleh macam, oh salah, tak balik dia pada awal. Jadi cuba macam tu lah ya. So we'll proceed with that until lunch time. And then after lunch, kita nak bagi lebih long untuk you guys to hands on. Alright, so before we pass back to Dr. Najwa, ada tak dari setiap meja concern, soalan yang berkaitan dengan polisi ke, yang berkaitan dengan apa-apa? Soalan-soalan lah yang nak ditanya, yang saya pandai saya boleh jawab, tak boleh jawab saya tak tahu.
Kita pakai yang aktiviti yang kita pakai yang apa lagi?
Yang macam spektrum tu kan? Raya kita pun dengar. Dah tak access tak?
Belum boleh access tu.
Kalau belum boleh access, mungkin kita buat
dia pun dia nanti dia akan ajarkan macam mana.
Okay.
Itu apa ke? LSP some feedback comment. How did it improve? Sekarang siapa yang buat ni?
Okay. We sedang melantik 3 orang IT yang akan station dekat IDET. Okay. Tetapi masih dalam proses lantikan lagi. Bear in mind, you all of us here will have to share that 3 IT. So
dia full time lah.
So seboleh-bolehnya ID yang 3 orang tu kita gunakan sebagai trainer jugalah. So, at least yang mana you guys boleh, yang mana yang lecturer boleh pick up sendiri, lecturer pick up lah. Okay? Tapi of course kalau dia dah ada kat sana, then
sejauh mana dia boleh tolong lecturer? Dia boleh,
dia takkan buatkan macam
dia tolong macam buat
pass lah macam tu tak. Tapi nak bantu train kita punya keyword sini. And that is in charge of training the lecturer. We don't do for the lecturer. We train the lecturer and we have specific dedicated trainer, which are the 3 SIM IDs yang kita akan lantik tu as the specific trainer for them.
So dulu dia video ada insert video tak ke video itu cakap pasal apa semua macam
sebab pasal ni Encik Sat to edit the video.
Okay.
So who can help us?
The 3% lah.
3%.
So we will have technical help.
The technical help.
Okay. But bear in mind because we have to share. Sejauh mana yang boleh belajar dan pick up sendiri untuk mencepatkan lah. Okay. So table language, ada nak tanya? Any questions? Any concern?
I think for me,
Edna has published this online.
Thank you. buat apa pun. Alright. Cuba pick one topic yang mudah. Cuba buat kan. Okay. So since you all dah ada yang ni, okay, yang MC set dulu pagi ya. So since you all dah ada yang tu, okay, kita akan sambung untuk seterusnya lah. Okay. Siapa yang belum complete yang form 2.0 tu, SIM development tu boleh buat, ambil masa ni untuk lengkapkan. Dan saya rasa jam tu penting, okay? Sebab kalau tidak nanti you over plan. Okay, cuba letak tengok jam tu boleh cukup tak untuk ini SLT. Okay. Overview of course. Okay, these are the things that normally kena ada lah. Title, overview or introduction to module, course description, course objective, duration, course learning outcome, how many topic, and how assessment will be. Okay, so yang ni saya rasa semua dah ada. Dalam form yang telah disediakan sebelum ni, structure, sequence of activities, details about resources. So yang form yang you all dah buat tu, I think is a good framework lah untuk your plan. Cuma kalau apa-apa missing part, especially on the time, time and then connection from one activity to another tu kena jelaskan. Alright. Okay, ni ada persoalan attendance. Tak ada attendance lah dalam UDL. Okay, tapi kita boleh check learning analytic dalam LMS, which will indicate or will give the information about how much the students spend time dalam kita punya LMS ataupun reviewing the content that provided for them. Okay. Then another question, do we need to have synchronous session every topic or module? Not necessarily. Tapi kalau tadi saya rasa 20% ada kan? So sebenarnya synchronous should only be online. Okay? Tapi tak boleh banyak lah sebab kita kata ni adalah ujian. Okay, of course objective, ni semua dah tahu, SMART. Okay, so end of topic 1. Nak charge.
Thank you.
Plan. So you can put teaching plan. It is always good to have to share your teaching plan. So student will know, what to expect. Kan? Tak ada surprise every week, kan? Tapi tak ada lah surprise lah sebab dia on their own. Tapi because the teaching plan is necessary so that they will know what will happen every single time. Okay, apa lagi? Okay, yang ni sebab saya ada banyak group, so I ask them to choose group. Okay, meaning that giving the necessary instruction before they see the first topic. Okay, whatever instruction, guidance that you should give, you bagi awal-awal lah. In fact, kita boleh buat pun introduction setting. So, dia tahu lah ni introduction setting. Okay. Okay, ni baru masuk topik lah. Topik, so dia akan nampak topik 2, 3, 4, 5, semua. Lepas tu ada course summary. Okay. So, course summary, congratulations, you have completed the 7 topics. Okay. Don't forget to take the midterm test to get a cyber log and manage patch. The patch, you got patch. Okay. We hope you are able to. Okay. And then, if you wish to enhance and enrich your knowledge about information security insurance, please click the YouTube link provided. We would like to take the opportunity to get feedback about this MOOC and so on. Okay. So saya pun ada peluang untuk dapat feedback juga. So I get from them. You boleh buat dekat yang kita feedback, kita punya sim. So katalah ada pelajar kata setiap they need this kind of information, so you can improve better. Okay. So, ni course summary. So ada introduction, ada course summary bawah-bawah, and then ada content. So it's up to you on how you would like to arrange your content. Kalau macam ni saya susun dia topik dahulu, and then ada activities, ada assessment. Satu section lah. Okay. For example, if I click the first one. Yang saya tanda tik-tik ni sebenarnya setting untuk So basically tak adalah beza sangat dengan konten yang kita dah buat sebelum ni kan. Tapi you have to make sure your instruction tu must be more clearer and direct. Yang tu kena tanya orang teknikal, dia kena satu lagi session. Dia tak boleh hari ni tak habis ni. Session untuk technical managing your that's how we do it in USIM lah. Kita bagi yang theoretical punya satu hari, lepas tu mapping, kita buat framework. Lepas tu hari satu hari untuk technical. Tu kita buat sama-sama lah. Macam kita nak set yang mana on tak on, yang mana kita nak set apa, ada sequence, prerequisite tu semua technical. Geng orang, kita panggil orang muda lah. Tapi saya rasa di setiap universiti ada yang jaga muda kita ni. Dia orang memang expert. Kalau tanya saya, saya akan ambil masa lama sikit untuk cari. Sebab kita buat, tapi saya tahu ke. Selama sikit nak cari jawapan dia. Okay, ni saya terus pergi ke topik dia lah. So again, we have the welcoming punya ni. Dear students, welcome to the class. Okay. Dia dah letak lah sikit gambar. Alright, and then you mention about who's going to teach. Kalau ni saya dengan Dr. Ilyas, saya the team. So Dr. Ilyas and myself, we handle this class for the semester. So saya bagi tahu saya handle apa, saya handle apa. So at the end of this course, okay. Kindly download and refer to the course teaching plan to understand better and so on. And then I tell them I'm using MS Teams for the live session platform. So this is the code, okay? Overview of information, glossary. Okay, we can prepare glossary. It is good to prepare a glossary in our content so that students will alert dengan terms yang digunakan dalam konten kita. Okay, itu ada slide. Ini slide lah. Okay. Ini topik 2. Okay, so saya letak gambar kalau ada live session. So I try to make my LMS ni jadi tempat reference pada student. Kalau apa-apa saya cakap tengok goals, kita panggil goals lah. Tengok goals. Kalau dia tanya, doktor macam mana ni? Saya okay, refer kepada topik ni, tengok apa benda goals. So ini respon pelajar. Okay, to be honest with all of you, memang susah nak dapat respon pelajar. Sebab online kan? Tapi we have to let them know that kita actually waiting for the answers. Kita melihat, we are monitoring. Kita tak kata kita buat digital content, then I'm going to see you end of semester. Kita sentiasa follow through apa yang kita plan. For example, kita kata, okay, this week 2, you are supposed to respond dalam Padlet about this topic. So, then you remind. Bila sampai week 2, okay, don't forget, you have to respond to my questions dalam goals about business. And then minggu tu, you keep on remind. And then, ada masa nanti kita kena cepat-cepat cari masuk dalam ni, cari siapa yang belum masuk. Petik dia nama seorang. Contohlah kita carikan siapa yang belum masuk. Kata okey, Ahmad Daniel, you did not respond yet. Please, Daniel and others who did not respond, you respond. Sebab satu tu je, tidak akan buat apa-apa. Okay? So once the first week, the first few weeks are very important to show that we are actually are there with them. Okay? Kita sentiasa monitor their progress. And then di arah pertama, kita sentiasa dia pula akan remind. Doktor, ni dah minggu kelima. Doktor dah tengok belum jatuh juga, kita dah respon. By that time, they will alert you pula. Okay? Looking forward for your response and so on. So this is the content lah. Okay? Yang ni sebab tak ada, tak cukup instruction lah. Ni contoh tak cukup instruction lah. Okay? Okay, for example, video lecture part 1, 2, 3, I did not put instruction on what we expected from this video. Tapi sebab benda ni saya guna, saya ada session berjumpa kan. So kita cakap dalam kelas. Kalau dalam scene, yang ni kena ada. Okay, please watch this video and focus on what? Okay, ataupun kita terus beritahu minit keberapa, ada apa. Ataupun dia kita boleh bagi aktiviti. Okay. Ini pun satu contoh lain. Subject. Okay. Okay, a little bit about the course. Okay, announcement, assignment. So dia letak awal-awal semua assignment-assignment semua. Okay, so depends lah you nak buat macam mana. Macam yang saya tunjuk tadi, saya letak assignment activity tu kat bawah. Okay, tu buat satu blok lah. So student tahu. Kalau kita kata okay, this week everyone should focus on assignment 1. So dia tahu ke mana nak cari assignment. Okay, yang ni untuk master course. Punya slide yang pertama tu saya save sebagai gambar. Setiap slide yang pertama saya save sebagai gambar, saya buat banner. Okay, so nampak penuh lah. Lepas tu topik kedua. Okay, dan topik ketiga, ni sebab kita main laju-laju buat je. So dia saiz besar kecil semua ada lah. Tapi ni pun nak kena arrange pada ni. Soalan kita pun ada develop satu template untuk situ. Okay, these are all the essential part of scene structure or outline of the scene, course description.
But to
So nanti sambil dengar, you cuba buat So what is this course all about? What are the content that you would like to put in about your course? Okay, so boleh buat dalam Word dulu ataupun PowerPoint about your description. Okay, the course description termasuklah jumlah jam that should be spent. Okay, ada exam ke, macam mana assessment dia, macam mana perjalanan program ataupun kursus tu, what are you expecting from the student. So semua dalam course description. Course objective, you already have the course objective, no problem. And then now we come to selection of content. Okay, selection of content. Jadi saya tunjuk contoh-contoh yang saya punya khusus lah, yang orang lain punya, nanti tengok saya boleh buka ke tak. Okay, what content best to explain, transfer, illustrate knowledge. Okay, we also can use multimedia. Maknanya berbagai media lah, multimedia. It could be text, picture, table, graph, infographic, calculator, audio, video, VR, AR. Saya tak pernah jumpa lagi course mana ada VR, but you can do that. Okay, kita boleh develop calculator to help our course. The issue about create or use others. Okay, so in this sense, we can create our own multimedia or our own content. We also can use others' content with acknowledgement and citation. Okay, intellectual property issue, and kita dah cerita, acknowledgement is important, right source of content or reference. Okay, creation content, text. Adakah kita nak buat storytelling ataupun active writing? Kita pulang our style, kita punya scene kan, kita punya style. Use hyperlink, bold keywords, use useful notes, tips, checklist to highlight content. You can also use mind map. Okay, ada banyak tools mind map kita boleh guna. Pictures, illustrations. Okay, ada yang can prepare video, kita panggil bite size. Okay, 10 minutes equal to 1 hour as well. So kalau sepatutnya kita mengajar dalam kelas 2 jam dan kita kena buat 2 video lah. Satu video 10 minit, satu video 10 minit. Kenapa kita buat kecil-kecil je, bite size? Why cannot we make 1 hour, 2 hours video? Because it is not a movie. It's a K-drama. Kalau K-drama 1 jam, aku rasa, dah habis. Kan? We are preparing a video. Kalau kita belum buat dalam komputer, kita bikin cantik, menarik, memang 10 minit ni sekejap je. Okay, kalau kita buat video dengan keupayaan kita, our focus is so much on the content ataupun creating a good video, kita rasa 10 minit sufficient. Okay? Audio, you can prepare audio by size podcast. Jadi saya rasa banyak podcast sebab student boleh dengar pada video-video masa. Contoh sambil kubas, sambil makan-makan, dia boleh dengar. Kalau video, dia kena duduk tempat dan tak tengok kan, tempat meja. So try to use audio as well. So audio especially for those yang ada special need. Kalau kita pelajar kita tak boleh nampak, jadi audio will help them. Illustration through the voice is very important. Interactive infographic, ini kita boleh guna lah web 2.0. Interactive video boleh guna apa nama dia? H5P. Saya terbalik. Itu dalam muda. Kita boleh buat interactive video. Very good, sebab you can prepare the content. Dia boleh pause untuk buat quiz dulu ke apa. Augmented ataupun virtual reality. Yes. Bukan sembilan. Ada banyak masa lagi. jawatan kan. So dia boleh guna phone ataupun ni scan dan kita nampak contoh anatomi. So dia boleh nampak layer by layer. Okay, creative interactive content are yang H5P ataupun dia boleh pakai untuk activate. Video plus activity to check what's
happening. This is right in the day.
Yang ni boleh guna media platform ada, macam-macam ada boleh try. Dan untuk video kita boleh guna yang free lah, Camtasia yang ni berbayar. Dan Camtasia pun berbayar dekat live dekat screencast only yang free. Screencast. Saya register awal-awal dulu, sekarang dia bagi yang basic.
Tak ada lesen.
Tak ada.
Kita pakai. Boleh. SPP tak? SPP ada dalam kita punya model.
Yang lain,
dalam. Yang tu boleh apa? Yang free je.
Sekarang ada banyak yang free kan.
Screen castingnya software kan?
Banyak.
Screen cast community. Camtasia pun ada yang free version. Saya selalu pakai Loom. Loom.com.
Then we also can have interactive materials. Kita boleh buat post and survey. Calculator, forum. Boleh letak lagu kalau ada kaitan. Saya letak movie. berkaitan dengan security. So saya cakap, tapi itu untuk enhancement saja, bukan main activity lah. Saya kata go and watch this movie, saya bagi dua list. Okay, and then
movie
tu 2 jam. So yang tu kira additional. Additional punya ni lah.
So you put 2 hours, 2 jam kan?
Tapi dia dia bawah, di bawah sebab yang tu bukan untuk ODL yang saya bagi movie tu. Sebab saya assume that will be dipanggil sultan punya ni lah kan? So sebab student memang bagi movie, so saya tak datang movie yang berkaitan dengan security, information security. So saya bagi hint. Okay, look for this topic, threats yang macam ni. So bila dia tengok, then I bagi padlet untuk dia orang jot down apa yang dia jumpa daripada movie tu.
Tapi dia tak masuk dalam SMP
kan? Tak masuk lah yang tu. Sebab sebab saya punya tu
ada dari dia.
Yes.
Untuk segi macam tu support lagi lah.
Enhancement.
Enhancement.
Ataupun enrichment. Enrichment of the students lah. Sebab dia kira yang tu kira dah applied lah. So dia learn about the threats and security issues, mechanism and so on. Itu dia tengok. All this one, dia dah tengok pun. Rupa dia tak perasan. Oh, macam inilah yang dimaksudkan dengan ni. Kan? So nanti mungkin tahun depan boleh tunjuk drama yang Malaysia baru buat. Pasal scammer, pasal security. Sebab saya dah sampai security. Dia boleh ambil dia punya drama-drama tu. Okay? Sebab student kalau bapak buka laju sikit kan.
Okay,
ambil lagi lah about learning. Social learners. Once we know our students, then we can choose lah all of this. Okay. Visual learners, draw diagrams, create graph, draw and so on. So when we are using these elements, kita boleh minta student buat student, draw diagram about apa-apa. Summary of something, okay? Or even draw a comic strip related to the content, okay? Dia boleh pakai apa-apa tools, kemudian dia upload di apa-apa content, okay? Then kita kena cari. The good thing is, we can pick the best and then use it for our next cohort, kan? Bahan-bahan yang bagus, okay? So this is again our content. Alignment. Okay. So kita cuba hari ini buat yang ni lah. Tentang overview, learning outcome, resources needed, self-directed activities,
self-assessment. Okay.
Alright. Just to share with you. Okay, about instructional design tadi. How do you usually start your course? These are the things that we have to write down dalam kita punya si. Okay? So, selalu bagi kita masuk kelas, assalamualaikum, hi everyone, morning, and so on. Semua tu, kita buat dalam bentuk text ataupun video lah. How do you tell the students on what to do once they have the resources and activity? Okay, so we give live instructions. Okay. So, satu cara mudah, kadang-kadang bila nak taip, kita rasa susah. Kadang-kadang kita cakap, okay, hari ini masuk dalam kelas kan? Bila nak taip balik, so it's not natural, it's not come naturally kan. So you can use this facility kan. Word with dictation dalam manusia pun. Percaya kat sini. You don't come to. Bila kita bercakap, dia automatically ni dah forward kepada text. So ni saya bagi cara mudah untuk kita buat instruction. Sometimes bila kita tarik tu, instruction kita susah. Bila kita cakap, senang. So, you can use these tools, record whatever you want to say, and then you edit. Okay? So, this is one fastest way for you to make the instruction. So, for our introduction, activities, I'll try to record. Use this one, please. Okay? Word dictation. Ini dalam bahasa sokongan. Lepas tu dah siap, copy dah tarik tu, buku dalam kita punya. Okay, just to share with you, I come up with this simple module template. Saya buat tahun 2018-2019. Okay. So sebenarnya, it comes with a guideline how to use it with minimal IT skills. yang ni sebenarnya untuk address blended pun lah. Yang ni masa tu kita belum buat PKP, tak buat online lagi. So kita ada masalah nak ada online punya session and so on. So saya buat ni adalah untuk blended. Okay, so start, prepare and collect the materials, organize material according to session. Saya ada buat folder. So masa tu kita buat, kita kata that folder kita mesti ada formation, materials, activities and assessment. Okay. So upgrade PNP materials using Web 2.0, modify PNP using project activities and upload, arrange material according to the activities and activities, creating template, we have to conduct the do some testing, security, update cost, so insert guideline and instruction, validate the cost by expert. Okay, thank you, that's good. So all of you will be reviewer to your friends, okay? In the MP session, okay? So so what I'm suggesting is actually two things. You kena ada ni lah. Folder, buat simple folder ataupun folder untuk kita punya kelas lah. So folder tu ada benda ni, okay? So now kita nak arrange information, actually about kita punya introduction, about the course content. You can have all the topics here, the materials, the teaching and learning materials and content for each topic, activities for each topic, assessment for each topic. Okay, ataupun kalau assessment ada dua, formative and also summative. Okay. First century skill, fossil, computation, critical thinking, collaborative, creativity. Okay. So, okay. So I end for topic 2. So basically, what you have to do dalam masa yang ada sekejap ni adalah untuk buat ni lah, buat satu topik ni. Buat satu topik, pilih satu topik yang you boleh fokus untuk kita upload kita barang. Okay, masukkan dulu. So sekarang ni semua dah ada yang ni, semua dah ada yang part yang ni. So make sure dulu kena tambahkan ada dengan dia punya instruction tadi. Instruction tu boleh pakai invitation tadi. Nanti bila kita masuk after lunch, kita boleh try to upload terus dalam kita punya platform. Okay? Boleh? Any questions? Kita ada satu jam, so you boleh prepare lah untuk petang. So saya petang ni saya harap kita boleh tengok lah beberapa contoh instructions, overview of the course. Kalau tak datang buat pun. Kita asal ada sejam, so sama ada you all nak baca punya video ke ataupun powerpoint ke, kita boleh buat ataupun nak buat rakaman ataupun nak buat typing instruction pun boleh. Nanti kita susun dalam kita punya. Okay, so saya tamatkan dahulu saya punya presentation untuk topic 2. Give you the time for you to do the task and then we'll start again app 2 lah. Okay. Okay. Boleh buat
buku lagi?
Boleh. So saya bagi semua your time to prepare. Thank you. nak hantar dekat mana?
Thank you.
Jadi kita start satu orang satu. Tak ada video tadi, tapi kalau kita sama video ni, 1 minit video, 1 minit video.
Yeah.
Terima kasih.